Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, every person's every joint must perform a charity every day the sun comes up. To act justly between two people is a charity. To help a man with his mount is a charity. Good word is a charity. Every step you take to prayer is a charity. And removing the harmful thing from the root is a charity. This hadith teaches Muslims many things. First of all, the hadith teaches us that all the joints of the body are great blessings from Allah. Not only the joints, but all the other organs and the parts of the body are great blessings of Allah, and we need to be thankful for all of them. We realize the importance of the joints and the parts of the body only when we lose them. These things, each and every joint is extremely important, you know, to perform the duties of the daily routine life. So we need to be thankful to Allah for all of them. And the best way to thank Allah is to utilize them in charitable act. Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, teaches in this hadith that charity does not only mean to give money to the poor people. Whenever we talk about charity, when we talk about sadaqah, the first thing comes in our mind is that to give money, to give some cash to the needy person. But Islam teaches us that this is not the only form of charity, but every good action, if a person helps himself or if a person is helping any other person of the community, that will be counted as charity. And Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, has given many examples over here. For example, if a person is going towards Salah, is going towards a mosque, so Prophet, peace be upon him, said every step towards the mosque is a charity. Obviously, if a person is going towards the mosque for prayer, he is going for his own benefit and it is not benefiting the other people of the community, but still it is counted as charity because it is something good. But most of the examples Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, gave in this hadith is about to help other people in their daily routine life. Like Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, is saying, even the removal of harmful thing from the path is a charity. And even a good advice to another person is a charity. So the hadith teaches us that Islam likes such people of the community who are the source of benefit for other members of the community. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, also said, خَيْرُ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَنْفَعُ النَّاسِ, the best among mankind is one who is a source of benefit for other people. So this hadith teaches us to be a source of benefit for everyone, utilize all the organs of the body in a positive way, and try to be a source of comfort for others. We can practice this hadith in many ways. The hadith is demanding us to give charity from each and every joint of the body. So there are 360 joints in a human body. So how can we do 360 charities? And that will be only the charity from the joints. We have many other organs and parts in the body. How can we give the charity on their behalf? So that is not something impossible or something too difficult. But if we are spending our life according to the teachings of Islam, according to the teachings of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, each and every step we take in our daily routine life becomes a charity. For example, when we wake up in the morning, we have to say the dua at that time. We say, Alhamdulillah, alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhin nushur. We have done a charity. Then we do wuzu, that is charity. Then we go out of the house for prayer and we say, Bismillah, tawakkaltu ala Allah, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, that is charity. Every step to the mosque is charity. When we go to the mosque, we say, Allahumma aftah li abawaba rahmatik, that is charity. The time we spend in the mosque waiting for fajr prayer, we are in ibadat. When we come back, every step is a charity. We go into the house and we say the dua of entering the house and so on. We have not even properly start our day and we have done so many charities up till this time. So when we spend our life according to the sunnah of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, each and every step becomes a charity. So doing so many charities is not impossible or it's not difficult. For a Muslim, we need to be spending our life, we need to spend our life according to the sunnah of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, for that. Besides that, Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, also said, if a person offers two rakats at the time of duha, we call it the prayer of chasht at the time of duha. Like after 9 a.m. till before midday, if we will offer two rakat prayer, which is known as Salatul Duha, that will be enough charity from all joints of the body. So that is also a way to thank Allah for all the joints of the body. But in our daily routine life, we come across many situations where we can help the people around us. So we should avail that opportunity to help them. Like we can help an old person or a blind person to cross the road. We can help a person and if he's carrying so many luggages with him, so we can help him to carry his luggage. If we are riding in a bus and we see that an elderly person enters into the bus and is looking for a place to sit and there is no space, so we can stand up and we can ask him to sit over there. These are the small kind of things and the small ways of kindness shown to other people. So we should avail these opportunities. And Holy Prophet, peace be upon him's life, is full of such examples. Like you must have heard that incident that once Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, saw an old lady. She was carrying a lot of luggage and she was going somewhere. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, took the luggage from her and he took her to the place where she wanted to go. And Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, served that old lady. He used to throw trash on the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, every day in the Meccan life. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, was always ready to help other people, not only his followers, not only the members of his community, but even he helped those who were his enemies and who teased him. So we need to develop this quality in our characters, that we need to be a source of benefit, source of comfort for others. May Allah make us a person like that. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.